cost less than Zimbabwean dollar. And guess what? Google it. Last year, the Zimbabwean dollar was the worst performing currency in the world. Now, if the Naira is now worth less than the Zimbabwean dollar, what does that make the Naira?
Useless.
Now, here's the thing. Why is the Naira worthless now? It's because of these loans that Buhari is taking. And what is he using these loans for? He's using loan $2 billion to build a railway in Niger Republic.
Yes.
He took a loan in Nigeria's name,
yes,
to build a railway in Niger Republic. What nonsense is that? What nonsense?
Yes.
What sovereign country does that? That you take a loan, not even money that you own, you take a loan and then you go and build the infrastructure because his father comes from Niger?
Yes, yes.
Because his first cousins, yes, are in Niger, he said so. Now, what else are they doing with the money? They are building a naval base in Kano!
Wait.
A desert! A desert! A naval base in Kano! Have you ever heard of that? I went to the United States Naval Academy at Annapolis. As a guest, I was invited.
Yes.
I spoke there. I saw a map. This is American police. Show them. But can we show you? Is it okay? This is American policeman. Does America have a naval base in any desert? No! I went to the United States Naval Academy. I spoke there. 2019. What nonsense? Which nation in their right mind will go and build a naval base in a desert with borrowed money? Think about that. No, that's illegal. Watch that guy. That guy might be a fifth columnist. So, think about that. Think about that. Now, let me ask you a question. Now, watch this. Look at this. This man is borrowing money. Yet, he has 10 presidential jets. If he needs money, why can't he sell those presidential jets?
Exactly.
Yesterday,
exactly.
Yesterday, he was here begging for money from the Dutch government.
Yes.
The Dutch government that he's begging for, they don't have 10 presidential jets.
Well,
think about it. They don't have 10 presidential jets. Now, he has borrowed money to pay these people. Look at them. Look at them. He has borrowed money to pay them. Criminals. Now, look at this. Look at this now.
Continuing,
they have brought some people to infiltrate us. Continuing now, this government says that they are not going to. Can somebody take that from that guy? That guy is an intruder. He's not one of us. Now, what we are saying there is that the Nigerian government, they said that they are not going to reveal the identities of sponsors of Boko Haram.
Okay, so now,
where do we go?
Right here.
Yeah, it's okay.
There's berries right there.
No, but can I stay here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now, the government, Buhari's government said that they are not going to expose sponsors of Boko Haram. Don't you want to know the sponsors of Boko Haram? And they said that they are not going to reveal the sponsors of Boko Haram. What nonsense? When EFCC people, when they said that they were, look, this government, we want to know who the sponsors of Boko Haram are. We want to know the sponsors of Boko Haram. So now, that they regret putting Buhari in power. That they regret northern elders. Why? Because nowhere is secure in northern Nigeria. Nowhere. And even if you think that you are going to collaborate with these people, if you think you are going to collaborate with them, ask yourself now, what happened to our brother, Omoyele Sowore? His own brother was killed by Esmen. So even if you collaborate with them, you don't have security. So now I'm telling you, right now, we want a situation in Nigeria whereby we can express ourselves freely. I was being interviewed. Okay, this man, Bola Tinubu, is in London. They are preparing him to be the next president of Nigeria. On election day, we hired drones. We took a picture. We took pictures of two young fans going into Bola Tinubu's house. Has he invited Bola Tinubu?
Never.
Yes, Bola Tinubu goes in and out of the presidential villa discussing with Buhari. Now they are doing pilgrimage to London. They are doing pilgrimage to London to see Bola Tinubu. Now this is a man. They are preparing a man, a corrupt man, to be our next president. Aisha Buhari's agency. Aisha Buhari's agency. He has not been arrested, he's not been tried. And so now we are saying that this man is now running the most corrupt government in Nigeria's history. And according to Transparency International, Nigeria is now more corrupt than at any time in our history. Going down to Nigeria house. We're going down to Nigeria house. We're going down to Nigeria house to check out of the house of town. Respect the police. These kids want to pass. Let's allow them pass. Respect the police. We are law abiding. Respect the police. Allow these kids pass.